She currently teaches high school mathematics in North Carolina. However, middle school is still her favorite. She has 3 boys in high school. God love you, because I have no idea how you're going to manage to do that. She grades papers while overlooking beautiful Lake Norman on her family deck. It is rumored that her school has no PA system, and Julie just yells a morning announcement. She is a Desmos Fellow who loves to help teachers learn innovative ways to incorporate technology into their math lessons. She does write a blog for math educators at ispeakmath.org. I'm guessing she'll have that shirt on at some point. Julie is the epitome of a cheerleader, right down to the blonde hair and blue eyes. Her squeal is distinctive as she yells her name and comes in for a hug. She's been described as the math energizer bunny. When Julie came to TMC 12, she knew she had found her tribe. She has been to every single TMC. Julie is well known for getting people up to break out in song or leading others in group dances in very public places. She has world-renowned car dancing skills. In fact, she scared one TMC 12er to death because she's so outgoing, and it took this person, I kid you not, 3 TMCs to get over it. Just being in Julie's presence can make your day brighter. How can you pack so much enthusiasm, inspiration, and genius into one perfect package? Julie's the best. So without any other further ado, because we've had enough, here comes Julie Reulbach, being a teacher leader. Let's build up.
Thank you. love, speaking to huge groups of people all the time, as much as possible. I was actually terrified to speak to all of you today. When Lisa first called me, I was literally speechless. And that
True.
That rarely happens to me. In fact, I think it was probably the first time Lisa's ever heard me for a loss of words. So I think that scared her a little bit.
No.
But I just thought of the enormity of this conference. I mean, this conference that's full of the most progressive and innovative educators in this country and beyond. And you guys are my people. Like, I've been tweeting with you guys for like 8 years. So, or more. So I thought of that. And then I thought of past keynote speakers and how incredible they were and how they impacted me. And I was like, oh crap, I can't do that. I was completely terrified. And I thought, and I said to Lisa, what? Are you serious? Like, why me? Like, I'm not special. I haven't like written a book. There are so many books now. I have not like started a math movement, right? I haven't done anything like that. I'm not Eli or Fawn. I mean, I'm not these people. And so I was like, I felt really kind of guilty about it. I don't know. I mean, do I have to tell you right now? And I felt so guilty even asking for time because, gosh, what an honor to be asked to speak to all of you brilliant people. So intimidating, but what an honor. And I felt guilty even asking for time. Like, I mean, I should just say yes, but I was just like, everything about me was screaming no. So I wrote, and I probably wrote, I don't know how many pages for how many weeks. Less than two, because Lisa's very timely. Before I was like, I don't know. And then she said to me, she said to me, Julie, we wanted you to speak because of your positivity. And we think that you'll be inspirational, and you're the ultimate MTBOS cheerleader. But then she said something that made me say yes, and that was, so Julie, you've got this. She said, I believe in you. We all believe that you can do this. You just have to believe in yourself. But I still kind of felt like an imposter. And so I want to ask all of you right now, have you ever felt like an imposter? So if you just raise your hand and say, I mean, make me feel that, oh, yay! A lot of posts about people not feeling like enough, and tweets and blogs. Take Alyssa, for example. This post really spoke to my heart. Am I basic, aka, am I a fraud? Alyssa, students all do fabulously. She gives them surveys, they're overwhelmingly positive. She is the teacher she has always dreamed of being. Yet, she's afraid her students are missing out, and she's afraid she's not enough. Why? Because of the myth loss? And I was like, wow. Alyssa, who is such an amazing educator that she buys personalized t-shirts for all of her seniors with memes on them that fit their personalities. That is something I can never do. She is an amazing teacher, and she feels like an imposter. And then I saw this tweet from Shelby. Hey, Shelby! She's new, and she's like, oh my gosh, I'm going to Twitter, and I'm not going to be cool, and I'm so nervous. And I'm like, we're all dorks, it's okay. But then Justin, and then Justin says, so true. This is actually imposter syndrome math camp. And so I was like, yep, it can affect all of us. I mean, I know the people in this community. I tweet with you every day. You guys blow my mind. What's happening? And I think it's a few reasons. And one of them is that, you know, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, social media effect. you guys are awesome and supportive. But if I have even just one amazing lesson a year, I am going to shout that out too. And I'm going to tweet it, and I'm going to blog it, and I'm going to be like, it was so great! Because I want to share that with all of you, and I want you guys to have that great experience that I had in your classroom too. And hopefully I'm having more than one, maybe I'm having two or three. And since you guys all are so fabulous, you all are sharing at least one, if not two, or three, or 100 maybe, awesome posts every year. So if you're following 500 people, think of the number of awesome posts, lessons, tweets you're getting in your feed every day. I mean, at the very least, I'd say 1,500, right? And even if you're not on Twitter every day, and you may not see all of those, you're going to see so many of them, and you're going to be like, wow, those are all so great, and I'm not doing all of those. But guys, we're math teachers. Let's do the math. There are 180 days in the school year. You cannot do 1,500 new lessons. No matter how energized and refreshed, like the best teacher out there with all the resources that doesn't need to sleep, was that Daniel Carlson who didn't need to sleep on David's thing today? It doesn't matter. You cannot do all of those. So we have to give ourselves a break. And we have to stop feeling like we have to do everything. But it's not just that, because I do love seeing all those posts, and those really uplift me. I love it. I keep posting, post more. That's my favorite thing about Twitter. But there's some other things out there that are kind of, I think, getting us down. Definitely getting me down. And one of those things are all of these good teacher posts. And I think these are supposed to be helpful, but God, they suck. Teacher. So much so, and so direct, and it's like, you good teachers do this, that if you're not doing it, guess what? You must be a crap teacher. It's too much. And sometimes it's not even good teacher posts. Sometimes yeah. They're even worse. I'm sure many of you, who's seen this? Raise your hand, who has seen this? Responsibility of an individual teacher. Not if they've had a bad day, not if they're having a bad year, a bad whatever, but it's your responsibility. If you are a good enough teacher, every student would be completely engaged and attentive during every class period of all times. What? Who is this person? Well, here's who this person is. He only follows 25 people. So he's not even having conversations on Twitter like we are, right? But here's the problem. He has over 116,000 followers. So even if you don't follow an empty tweeter like this, look how many people saw that tweet. It was favorited or liked over 1,000 times. And this was just 700, and then a couple days was 1,000. It was retweeted, it was responded to. So even if you don't follow this, you're still gonna see it. And you know what they say about not reading the comments? Yeah. I did. So then other edu thought leaders hop in like, yeah man, spot on. You got that right. Teachers choose how they teach. Like it's an indictment. No teacher is choosing to do a bad job. Don't teach. Let me tell you right now, if you've forgotten or maybe you don't know, teaching is hard. We are working so hard to do everything that we've been assigned to do, plus everything we want to do, we see, plus everything everyone is telling us to be a good teacher, that we are burnt out and we're exhausted. We get exhausted. And when that happens, yeah, guess what? I come in and I have a really bad lesson one day, or 2 days, and at the end of that day, I do feel bad, and I do feel like I'm not a good teacher, and those things affect me. And then, sorry guys, but this one is on us. We love learning and doing things, right? And we get so excited about that, but sometimes we're maybe unintentionally not so nice to each other on Twitter. And we can't help it. We are just so excited that we don't mean to be negative. In fact, while I was writing this speech, so I posted, yeah, I don't want it to be worksheet driven or boring. I want to inspire these kids. Yeah. Well, thank goodness I have a great friend named Sam who was like, hey, Julie, don't knock worksheets wholesale. And I'm like, oh, I did that. And I felt terrible about it because I know that's not who Sam is. He's amazing. And I should not make blanket statements like that. And I didn't mean it, but you know, sometimes we do it. And Sam knows me, so he knows I didn't mean it. But how many people follow me that don't know me and maybe think I did mean it? So I think we just have to be a little more conscious of what we put out there. You can be excited about something, but I think that we should definitely be trying to put out positive instead of negative. And I've seen that a lot lately. Sam pushed back on me, and I've seen other teachers who also have started pushing back on Twitter. They're like, oh no, 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 no. Hey, edgy thought leaders, back up. And I love it. And then I'm also seeing things I really love, like this tweet from Matt. He was like, hey, teachers, I'm a teacher. I see you. We see you. It's hard work. And thank you for doing a great job. Because as teachers, we should know this, even though we forget, and that is, there is no one way to be a great teacher. No one way. So I'm going to share some things that I see in my feed a lot because they're my friends, and so I see this all the time. So I feel this too. There's the great Sam Chong, who creates individualized curriculum his own every year for every class he teaches. And then he blogs about it, and he comes to conferences and helps other people do it. There's Fawn here in spirit, who actually makes problem solving a part of her curriculum every single day. There's Sweens, who makes amazing songs and dances so the students can remember the concepts. And then he goes one step further with props and YouTube videos. There's Jonathan, who's encouraged so many kids to take calculus who never had before in his school. He's created this varsity math club that kids love. He does laser tag for his whole club in his cafeteria at the end of the year. There's Maddie and Chris, who talk in class and have great discussions and have made debate critical. And then there's Elizabeth, who does talking points. I've tried it so hard. And these are just my close friends, and I see their stuff all the time. And I'm like, dang. Do all of those things. I mean, I can't do some of those things at all. I can do some of those things some of the time, but I definitely can't do all of those things. Look at how different they all are. Look at all the different things they do. But guess what? They're all different, and they're all great, great teachers. And I love this tweet from Anna Vance yesterday. I was trying to put Sam's words on there, which I'm going to like Anna's response. How refreshing is it that no one does all the things? Guys, we can't do all the things. That would be crazy. And then I saw this amazing graphic that I just love. And I really think this is what we need to think of. This graphic is, okay, here's imposter syndrome, right? Like Alyssa, I'm doing this. They're missing out on all of this. But that's not what it is. I'm doing this. Alyssa's doing this. Sean's doing this. Sam's doing this. We all are doing about the same amount of things. We all know about the same amount of things. We're all doing some of each other's things. We're all overlapping. But you know what? That's okay. We're all doing those things. And that means I'm not an imposter. And that means that you are not an imposter either. In fact, you are enough. who knows what works best and what doesn't in classrooms and for teachers? And who knows what effect programs, curricula, and testing has on students? Teachers do. We know that. We are with these students every day. We see it. We feel it. And so it's our voices that we need to hear. It is our voices that we need to support each other. And we do not need to be listening to people who have never or even rarely taught. We need to listen to each other. Because we want to change education for the better, and we are doing that. We are making a positive impact on education just from the things we're doing, from being here, from tweeting. You guys are all so talented, very, very talented. Administrators are listening. People are listening. The world is listening. We're having an impact. And what education truly needs is teachers as leaders. So what I want you guys to do is I want you to tweet, I am a teacher leader because. So let's see the phones. Let's see it happen. The Twitter math can. Let's do it. I am a teacher leader because. I'm kind of glad my Twitter's not working because I see some smirking around here. I figure Clayton's charred out more than I am. I'm really bad with wait time. I'm sure. Some of you may be thinking, hey, Julie, I'm a first-year teacher, or this is my first TMC, or are there any pre-service teachers in here? Anyone? We should have a couple of those. I don't feel like a teacher leader, but I've got to tell you something. Just by being in this room, you are already a teacher leader. You had to find this conference buried deep in the Twitter labs, right? No administrator made you go. In fact, you probably had to beg for funds, which most of you probably didn't get. So you had to find a conference yourself, you've paid your own way, and you're spending your summer break with a bunch of math teachers. That's commitment. And you guys are in the minority. And I don't think I thought of this before, because when I come here, I'm so surrounded by so many amazing math teachers. But when I go back to my school, how many and think about your schools, how many other teachers are on Twitter and sharing on Twitter and participating in a community like this? And how many are even sharing outside of their classroom? So just the fact that you're here and learning already means that you've taken the first step to being a leader. So Christopher Danielson, TMC 15, I love this keynote, it was so good. These are things that intimidate me at night when I'm sleeping, thinking about my keynote. But his message was, find what you love and do more of that. And I love that, wow. Find what you love. It's okay if it's different. It doesn't have to be somebody else's amazing classroom, debate, talking points, whatever that thing is, that's their thing. Find what you love. And do more of that. Well, today I want to push that message a little further. I want you to find what you love, do more of that, but I want to make sure that you please share that. Share what you love, share share your passion. Because guys, you really may have no idea what effect you're having on somebody else. You don't know who's reading that tweet or how it's making them feel or who you're reaching, but you are reaching people. And just like there's no one way to be a great teacher, there is no one way to be a teacher leader. But it starts with sharing your passion in a way that you are comfortable with. And it doesn't have to be amazing. Like, I don't write a book, right? I write a blog, you know, and I tweet a lot. But some people do. Some people are amazing at writing books and sharing their passion that way, and that helps so many of us. Other people create these incredible websites. They have these awesome ideas, and then they're sourced by lots of people. Everyone jumps on, and I look at these, and these help me. They're so amazing. It's something I can't do, but I love it. We have Global Math and other virtual conferences. Sam's starting one, and you can participate in that. He's calling for presenters right now. Global Math, they are always looking for people to present. You could be a leader in that way. They would love to have you. Some people write blogs. That's a great way to lead. And we do the Exploring the Math Twitter Blogosphere Initiative. We are always begging people to write blogs. That's an amazing way to lead if you would like to do it that way. Other people are starting initiatives like My Favorite Friday to help encourage people to blog who are already blogging and like they're trying to get more people in the community. We have amazing Twitter Math Chats. And Twitter Math Chats are awesome because you can be there that night or you can see them later. But I can tell you right now, if you ever wanted to moderate any one of these chats, just tweet somebody and they would be like, oh yes, we would love that. Like, look, you can read all the chats. Right? It would be great. Some people have realized the importance of meeting face to face. And so in their own communities, they are starting local MITBOS and MTBOS get-togethers. It's great. And that's really important, actually. So a great way to lead, if you're like a person who likes to organize, is to do this. You know, just email some teachers. I literally got on the school websites and just copied a bunch of math teacher addresses and just blitzed everybody. Like, you could just do that and start something. And we really need that because NCTM is pretty expensive to go to. The registration is kind of high, especially if your school's not paying. And right now, a lot of people, it's during the school week, and it's hard to do. So a lot of times, the smaller conferences like this are in the summer or on the weekends, and that's more easy. That's more doable for more teachers. And guess what? Glenn will help you. Hey, Glenn.
Hello, Glenn.
So really, I just want to make you guys know that when I first started doing this talk, when I was talking there with Sam, Sam was like, Sam pretty much wrote the keynote, I'm just speaking. But I was like, okay, teacher leadership, here we go. So first you get on Twitter, then you write a blog, then you go to a conference, then maybe you write a book, and then I'm like, wait, what? Like, I don't want to do half of that. And Sam was like, no, remember, we're not leveling it. There are no levels, right? Teacher leadership isn't a ladder to be climbed. Right? Teacher leadership is what you want to do to support another teacher. And even if you only support one other person outside of your classroom, you are being a leader. Because there's no best way to be a teacher leader. Writing a book isn't necessarily better than writing a blog post. There are so many ways to lead. You can come up with a hashtag that encourages people to blog all year long. You can actually highlight other educators to motivate yourself and them. These are all things that look small, but are really large. In fact, you may not even know how large they are. Your one tweet of support may have more of an effect on someone than if they read an entire book by another educator. The size of your participation and your leadership, that's not what's important. because you don't know how big of an impact you may be having. So what I want you guys to do is I want you to be sure to make this time to talk and share and support each other. And not just now, when we're like, whoa, TMC, right? And in August, we're all like ready to go in September. You know, not just now, but in January, and February, and March, right? When you go into survival mode, when you are like wanting to hunker down and just push everything out and stop sharing and stop connecting, guys, that is when we need it the most. That's when you need the support the most, and that's when everyone else needs it too. And in everything I've participated in my life, there's one thing I've learned. The more you put in, the more you get out, right? The more you put in, the more you get out. So please, do not disappear and fade away. Because not only do we need you, but you need us. You need to hear from other teachers who are like-minded. And teachers here, I feel, are very like-minded. This is my tribe. I've been tweeting with you guys forever. I've missed family vacations to come to TMC. Like, this is my place because I come here. Usually when I arrive, I'm like, I never want to teach again. I'm done. But by the end of TMC, I cannot wait to get back and just be with my students again. This exhausting conference re-energizes me more than anything else. And that's what we need. We need each other. We need to hear each other's voices. Not just now, but all year long, so we don't forget. I don't want you to forget that you're not an imposter. And I want you to remember that you are enough all year long. Not just today, not the beginning of the year, but when you're the most tired, when you feel like you've done a bad job. Remember, you may do a bad job some days because you're working so hard every other day to be amazing. You are enough. So what I want you guys to do right now is I want you to stop for a moment and I want you to think about something that you could do to support another teacher. What is your passion? What is comfortable for you? But I also want you to push yourself. We're all here to take that step together. What's the next thing that you can do? And oh yeah, I want you to tweet it. So I'm gonna give you some time to tweet again, because you know, that's my thing. Alright, so I hope that whatever you wrote today about how you're a great teacher and how you're a teacher leader and how you're going to grow as a teacher leader, I hope that you remember those things and I hope you use that sticker and that you don't forget that you're enough, because this is the most incredible group of people that I've ever been around. You guys inspire me every day. And I'm so excited that we're all going to be teacher leaders together. So, so don't forget to be a teacher leader and build up, right? There are